Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about JLayeredPanes in Java, so you can do cool stuff like this, such as stack components on a GUI frame. So let's get into it. Before you reach the end of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe so that we together can challenge and defeat the mighty YouTube algorithm. Hey everyone, I'm going to be teaching you guys about the JLayeredPane. What this is that this is a swing container that provides a third dimension for positioning components. So think of it like the depth or the Z index. So this is very similar to a J panel, except we can also specify different layers on the JLayeredPane. We can have components be stacked on top of one another or underneath. So let's begin by creating an instance of the JLayeredPane. So what we're going to do here is just type in JLayeredPane. We need a name for this pane, so we'll call this just layeredPane with a lowercase l equals new JLayeredPane. Now we're also going to need a JFrame setup, and we've done this in previous videos, so if you need a JFrame, feel free to pause the video and type all of this in. So make sure that the layout manager is set to null. Now what we're going to do with this layered pane is actually add this to our JFrame, but first we're going to set the bounds for this. So we're going to type in the name of our JLayeredPane dot set bounds. And then I would recommend just picking the same dimensions for your JFrame, or you can pick a different size, but I think for this example we should have it be the same. So I'm going to set this where X is 0 and Y is 0, so this will begin in the top left corner. I want this to be 500 pixels for the width and 500 for the height. Now what we're going to do is actually add this layered pane to our JFrame, and I'll do that right underneath where we instantiate this JFrame. So frame.add layered pane. So now we have a layered pane attached to our JFrame, and now we can add components to our layered pane here. So let's take a look to see what we have so far. Here is our JFrame. It is 500 by 500, and there is an invisible layered pane attached to here. So we'll actually need to add some components so we can see this in action. So we'll need to add some, maybe JLabels or some other components to this. I like JLabels, so let's add those. So JLabel, and we'll call this label label1 equals new JLabel. And we're going to take label1 and set this to opaque. Set opaque true so we can actually see this. And let's add a background color. So label1.setBackground. And then we'll place the words color.red. And since we're not using a layout manager, we're going to set the bounds for this label on our layered pane. So label1.setBounds, and we'll have this label begin where X is 50, Y is 50, and for the dimensions, this will be 200 by 200. All right, so let's do the same thing, and we can just copy these and make maybe two more labels. So we'll have label1, label2, and label3, but make sure to change it here as well, so you'll want these also to be their respective labels. So label2 for this paragraph here, and then label3 for everything here. Let's change the second label to be maybe green, the third one to maybe blue, and we'll also change the bounds. So I'll have the second one begin where X is 100 and Y is 100. And then for label3, I'll have this begin where X is 150 and Y is 150. So what we need to do next is actually add all of these labels to our layered pane. So let's do that after we instantiate our layered pane. So we can add that right here. So type in the name of your layered pane, dot add, and the name of the component that you want to add. So let's add label1, and let's do the same thing for each of these components. So do the same thing for label2 and label3. So let's run this and see what we have so far. Now label1 is our red box, so the first component by default that is added to your layered pane will appear on the top, the next one will be underneath, and so on and so forth with that pattern. So we can actually change the order in which these are stacked on top of each other. And with layered panes, there's actually a name for each layer. Here's a visual. All right, everyone. Well, here's a visual of all the layers within a J layered pane. So each of these layers actually has a specific name, and you can specify which layer in which you want to add a component. And when these are all stacked on top of each other, it adds some depth to a program. So it appears that visuals are stacked on top of each other. Now, you don't have to remember all these names. There's actually a shortcut I'm going to show you guys in just a moment. But let's begin just by adding two components to our default layer and maybe one to our drag layer. So let's head back to our program and try that. So with label 1 and label 2, what we're going to do is that if we want to add this to the bottom layer, which is the drag layer, we're going to add the component followed by a comma, then type in J layered pane dot. You can actually pick the layers from here. So the bottom one was default. So let's see if we can find that default layer. So let's copy this and add this to label 2. Then let's take label 3 and add this to the top layer, which was drag. So I have an extra comma there. Let me fix that. Okay, so that was drag layer, which is right here. So when we run this, the blue box is actually going to appear at the top, and the rest are at the bottom. So there's actually a shortcut for this, because let's be honest, we're not going to remember all the different layer names and their order. So what we can do in place of typing JLayeredPane dot, then pick a layer, what you can do is just add a number, and there's an associated number with each layer. Let's say we want the base layer, that is 0. But we need to do one more thing just besides place a number here. We need to use the wrapper class. So type in integer dot value of, and then place the layer number. So if we want this at the bottom, we can just place layer 0. So just type in number 0. And let's add label 3 on top of that. So we can just copy this and say integer dot value of 1. And then let's place the green box at the very top. So we'll say integer dot value of 2. You could also pick a higher number here as well. So what ends up happening now is that our green box is at the very top. So the higher the number, the higher the placement is when you stack these on top of each other. So that's really the basics of J layered panes. You add components to a J layered pane, specify the layered number or by name, and then add the layered pane to your frame or other container. So if you'd like a copy of all this code, I'll post this in the comments down below. And well, yeah, that's the basics of using J layered panes in Java. Hey you, yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.